He knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave Explains.
Hey guys, for today's problem, we want to be able to draw R2-chlorohexane. That's it. We just want to be able to draw R2-chlorohexane. So if this seems confusing, you're going to want to go back and review my tutorials on nomenclature, as well as the Kahn-Ingold prelog convention in terms of being able to assign R and S. Okay guys, so when we draw structures from names, what we want to do is first take a look at what the parent molecule is. So clearly we see that this is a hexane. So hex is the prefix that means six carbons, and then ane is the suffix that means it is an alkane, which is a fully saturated hydrocarbon. So we know that we are going to have a six carbon parent chain, and we also know that on carbon two, there will be a chloro group. So we have, I've drawn the two possibilities for 2-chlorohexane, right? And so what we also want to be able to do is draw the one that has R stereochemistry. And so the way we're going to be able to do that, let's understand that these are the two possibilities, right? Because we can either have the chlorine, it's on carbon two, but it can be either a wedge bond or a dash bond. Now we have to choose the one that that exhibits R stereochemistry. So let's take a look here. What we want to be able to do by Kahn-Ingold prelog is assign the priorities of the four, whoops, that's a hydrogen. Okay, so remember that Kahn-Ingold prelog goes by atomic mass, and we go one carbon at a time. So what are the four atoms that this carbon is attached to? This carbon is the chiral center, and so we're going to want to take a look. We know that chlorine for sure is the heaviest. So that's number one. We know that hydrogen is for sure the lightest. So that's priority four. Now over here we have a carbon and a carbon. Now those two carbons tie, and we should also make a note that it's very tempting to look at this entire big group and say that this beats this methyl. And in this case we might be right, but you will be led astray at some point if you think that way. We really do have to put on our blinders and go one atom at a time. So what we do is we say carbon and carbon, well that's a tie. So what atoms are those carbons attached to? Well, this carbon is attached to hydrogen, 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 while this one is attached to hydrogen, hydrogen, carbon, right? We have the two implied hydrogens there, as well as this carbon, whereas this methyl carbon is simply attached to three hydrogens. Now, the way that works is it's essentially like these hydrogens cancel, those hydrogens cancel, but then this carbon is going to beat that hydrogen by mass. And so in this case, it does occur that this will be priority two and this will be priority three. Now, once again, in order to assess R and S, we have to have the lowest priority group away from us. Now, fortunately, in this case, that is already happening because the dash bond hydrogen, which again is going away from us, past the board, is the furthest away from us. So we can simply assess from 1 to 2 to 3. We see that from 1 to 2 to 3, we are going in clockwise fashion. So that is an R stereocenter. Okay, so this did end up being the correct one. And then for this one, we know that this one is going to be S because it is the opposite stereochemistry. And if we want to assess R and S on ones like these, we have two options. We can either imagine ourselves behind the board. And so right now, if I'm on the other side of the molecule from where you're standing, I can look at the chlorine that's coming towards me, the rest of the molecule going that way, and then the methyl here, and I see that as counterclockwise, which is S. But if you have a hard time with spatial reasoning, that instead we could pretend that this is a wedge, right? So if we pretend that this is a wedge, we're going to assess that as R the way we just did, but then you have to reverse it to S, because anytime we swap two groups as we would, the chlorine and the hydrogen, swapping them to make the hydrogen being away from us, you are inverting the stereocenter. So if you invert the stereocenter to make it easier for yourself to assess R and S, you must then invert your answer back to reflect the original molecule. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.